Welcome, listeners, to Parks' Rant, episode 20. Today's date is Sunday, March 12th, 2017. We hope you enjoy the show that will be provided to you momentarily. I know what you guys are sitting there thinking, what the fuck was that, first off? And what the heck, did you say it's Sunday, March 12th? Wasn't the last episode on Sunday, March 12th? What the fuck is going on? Hold on. Are we going back in time? No. You're not freaking out. I'm doing two today because I was not able to get the ones in last week. And since I got a little bit of time right now, I'm going to try to pump this one out. It's probably not going to be uploaded today because the other one is currently uploading that you guys will hopefully have already watched. So as soon as that one's done, I'll start this one. But it's probably not going to be up until tomorrow morning, Monday, March 13th. So that's when you'll probably be watching that one. But here I am again. Anyway, and I'm sitting here being creepy with my fucking operator woman bitch voice. Man. Yeah, gotta start out somehow. Some interesting way. Gotta be all, you know. That's how we do shit around here. Gotta be acting fucking more weird since Miss Whiskey and Coke is gone, obviously. On vacation. I'm here with Mary Jane, where the fuck she went. She was visiting for a little while. She might have just disappeared. Who knows? Speaking of missuses and womenses and freaking big trannies that think they're women, but they're not. I believe it was on Wednesday. That was National Women's Day, wasn't it? Was that Wednesday? Yeah, I think that's what it was. And, yeah, that was kind of another ordeal. I mean, that thing was fucking seemed kind of pointless, don't you think? You know, I was expecting on that day, since there's another freaking, like, all the women were saying, we're going to take the day off. We're not going to be out here and freaking support men. We're going to show the country what would happen if you know, women had just disappeared. So I'm expecting, you know, when I found out this crap was going on, I was expecting, I'm like, oh, dude, there's going to be no fucking traffic. You know, anywhere, so I'll probably get to work faster. Across the country, there's probably going to be statistically a whole lot of less vehicle accidents that day. There's probably going to be a whole lot less domestic abuse claims that day. You know, I expected a whole bunch of crap to change since women weren't supposed to go to work. Or they said they weren't going to go to work because they were protesting. They were showing what women can do. You know what I've found out? Fucking that, everything was the same. Traffic still sucked. I still went to work. People were still there. Businesses were open. Nothing. Not a fucking difference. Way to go, ladies. Way to really prove your point. That fucking, when you're like, we're going to show them what it's like without us. And, yeah, world kept turning. Nothing happened. You guys didn't go to work and everything turned out fine. I don't know what, maybe some of these women's fucking definition of taking off from work is just like, I'm not breastfeeding my kid. I'm not doing the dishes today. You get your own fucking groceries and you cook it, you dirty bastard with your fucking back fat and armpit hair and fucking bald mustache. So maybe they just fucking were defiant to their husbands and they're just like, fuck it, we ain't doing shit. Fuck you guys. I ain't doing nothing. Nah. The women at my work still fucking showed up, so it must not have been that big a thing. And when I mentioned it to the girl at my work, she was all like, you don't understand, women need respect and all this stuff. It's like, if you fucking support this so hard, why are you here? Why the fuck did you come into work if you say that, like, shit won't run without you? And you're going to prove a point. And you want to support the cause. Why are you here? Because you probably think it's just as fucking stupid as I do. It's a fucking another waste. A waste of fucking time. You know? It ended up just turning in, from what I saw on social media, into another fucking thing where all the women were out just bitching about Trump. cheering the same shit. Hell no, Donald Trump's got to go. Or whatever the fuck they're singing. That chant fucking, like, it gives me a fucking headache. Every time I hear it, just when I said it right there, like I just felt the back of my neck tightening up. You know, it's just like, it's fucking annoying, first off, and it's annoying and it's not getting anything done. So I don't get it. I just don't fucking get it. It's just another fucking reason for all these fucking women to go out and fucking menstruate and complain about shit. It's not really a problem. So fucking whatever. I was actually hoping when I was driving to work on Wednesday that I would find like a group of these women on a corner protesting or whatever with some pickets or just, you know, making a scene somewhere. Because I was going to end up going to work, putting my shit away, or getting started in the office. I was going to go take a break. I was going to go over to the electronics store. I was going to buy one of those megaphones, and I was going to go out there and have my buddy record this. Because I really wanted to go out and like kind of give him a fucking speech just to get him all riled up, you know. I was going to go out there with the freaking megaphone and be like, "Attention, clams! Go back to work! You're all adults. There is no wage gap. You guys get paid less because you do less. Yoga pants aren't, or leggings aren't pants." I was going to go out there and just fucking piss them off. "You guys out here is probably 90% of the reasons why nobody fucking respects you at work. Stop being lazy, you fucking hoes." Oh man, I would have probably got my ass beat, but it would have been fucking well worth it. You guys would have loved to seen that happen. I would have posted that shit on YouTube and just fucking let it go. You know, that's just out there just saying all the most derogatory shit to women just to get them riled up. You know, just because I think it'd be fun. You know, I'd go out there and be like, you know, like, go tell them, like, start walking around, like, talking to them. Like, "You know what? I'm thinking about, like, what would you think if somebody opened a store, you know, kind of like, there's Kids R Us, there's Babies R Us, there should be Ute R Us. A store called Uterus, because women need a store just like the babies and the kids. Because you guys are all the same. You guys all sit there and cry and overreact about everything. Fucking everything. The smallest shit. Women, babies, kids fucking cry and overreact. You know, you can see women that'll like fucking get like a drink. You see like a little kid spill some milk on himself, he fucking starts crying. A baby does the same thing, he spills food on him. A woman will do the same fucking thing if she spend enough time getting ready to go out. Spill like some wine on her. "Oh my God, what am I gonna do?" Same thing. Over. It's fucking liquid. It touched some cloth and it might have touched your skin, which is pretty good at, you know, like repelling shit from getting within your body. So stop whining. It is a fucking accident. It happens. Move on. You'll still wake up tomorrow. Unless that's like the one that fucking pushes you over the edge and you just fucking go fly off a bridge. "I can't take it! I can't take it anymore!" Bah! Yeah, I don't know. Like, some women just fucking overreact. It's not all women are crazy. But 99% of them are fucking out of their mind in some way at some point. It got quiet. My dryer turned off. You know, I've seen crazy fucking women like, I think last weekend, I was walking home from the gym, and there's this lady in her car. She's got like a fucking pantsuit on. You know, fucking all, like, "Look at me, I'm this businesswoman," in her fucking nice car. And she's fucking like on her phone. She's got her phone in her hand, and she's fucking driving. I'm like, first off, you shouldn't be on your fucking phone, you dunce. But she's doing that, and she's fucking, like, screaming at her phone, just... You know, and, like, super violent yelling into her phone. I couldn't hear her, because she's inside of her car. But just, like, the way she's just, like, flopping her head around, her hair flying everywhere. She really reminded me of, like, a fucking female Hitler. Or however the fuck the Germans talk. His name's Metzger Lincoln. It was fucking crazy. I was like, dude, what can you possibly be that mad at? Okay, I get to, but like, I've never seen anybody like scream so hard like that before, where they're just fucking like a bobblehead. Just, that was crazy. And then, like, you're doing it in your car when you should be driving. Being super pissed off at someone on the phone. You're on the phone, which is a distraction, and then you're, like, mad at them, so more of your attention is going to go to that. So, like, you're a fucking hazard. Get off the road if you're going to be fucking Hitlering it to somebody that fucking pissed you off. You know? There's other times that freaking women go nuts, too. Like at the iHeart and freaking Music Radio Awards. Fucking women were losing their fucking mind. That was on last weekend. I'm watching it. And these fucking girls in the crowd are just like... Like fucking, like fucking half crying and half like too excited to be wherever they are. Fucking because like, you know, fucking like, what's his name? Like Shawn Mendes is fucking standing next to him. Oh my God, I gotta stretch his back pocket. He's got pants. Oh my God, I want to suck his dick. Fucking like, I just like, how are you that overcome with emotion just from like being near somebody that you don't even fucking know? Like, I've never fucking lost my mind that hard. I've been next to fucking celebrities. You know, I've met fucking a few celebrities. I don't fucking, like, I go up to them if I want to talk, be like, hey, man, you know, I saw you do this, whatever, big fan, you know, can I get a picture? That's it. I'm not, like, freaking the fuck out. It's like, calm down. Speaking of the iHeart Music Awards, you know, like, I watched most of it, not all of it, because for some reason the fucking, like, I knew it started at 5, but then I couldn't find the damn channel, and like when I did find the channel, it didn't say it was on until 7, and then it apparently was on at 5, but I don't know, wherever the fuck the problem was, it just, I didn't get to see the whole thing. But you know, I'm sitting there, I'm watching these awards, I was like, who, like, what determines a nominee in that one? Is it actual, like, you like people on the radio currently? Is that how it goes, since it's iHeartRadio? Or is it just people who put out music that year? Like, how does that work? I don't know, like, what determines someone to be nominated in that? You know, because, like, I didn't see any, like, the big-name people there for some of these, you know, awards. It's like, fuck, where were these big-name fucks? Like, Metallica, I didn't see them. Maybe they were there, but I didn't see it. No, I don't think Justin Bieber was there. I know he's a bigger name, but it's just like, where are the fucking big world famous fucking people? There were some of them, but not all of them. You know, in these nominees, I didn't get it. I just fucking didn't get it. You know, with like best rock song or whatever, a rock album went to like fucking Green Day. I mean, really? That was the best? I know they're fucking huge, but that was the best? There's probably some other big-ass ones that are like, where's Volbeat? They're fucking big. They're huge. Maybe not super, like, well-known in the States, but they're fucking huge. Now, I just didn't see them. You know, Bruno Mars is there. I guess he's pretty big. I'm not a fan of his music, honestly. But I did watch his performance. The dude can fucking sing. He's fucking really good. I don't know what's with his, like, fucking old-school, like, Elvis Presley fucking hairdo he's got going on, but like, the dude's super talented. I can't complain about him. I'm just not into his music, so I'm just like, whatever. I wasn't fucking super into it. I was just saying, whatever. I saw him at the Super Bowl, you know, when that, a few years ago on TV. Wasn't impressed by that either. I was like, meh, whatever. Some other name, this guy Shawn Mendes, like I was saying earlier, that freaking girls were losing their mind on. I've never even heard of that guy. I don't know who the fuck that was, and everyone was fucking losing their shit over this dude. And I'm sitting there watching, like, I guess the dude's like 17 or something, or 18. Super young guy. My first thought is like, this is going to be the next fucking Justin Bieber train wreck. Any of these fucking young kids that come into the music industry and fucking start becoming super huge, super fast at that age, like, they just fucking, they snap. They lose it. They don't know what the real world is anymore. That's the problem with celebrities. It's just they get their ass kissed for so fucking long, they lose track of the outside world. They don't know what real problems are. They don't know what real struggles people are going through. They have no idea. That's why you always hear them bitching about crap that's, like, not really an actual problem. Oh, you killed Cecil the Lion, you monster. How could you be drilling for oil over here, you monster? Whatever, you don't know what the fuck's going on, so shut up. Yeah, there's some other freaking weird things at the show. Like, I saw this girl that was presenting the award. I don't know who the hell it was, but she had... She wasn't even wearing a bra or a top at all. What she got was a fucking belt, like a big belt, like this fucking big, like 3 or 4 inches, and then like wrapped it around her chest and squeezed it tight around her fucking tits. And I was like, oh, this is a top. And I'm like, no, that's a fucking belt. Since you don't know what a fucking belt is versus a goddamn bra, you're half a damn tard. I don't know how the fuck you ever got as much money as you did to be on stage, but you are fucking retarded. Belts, waist, bras, boobs. That's where those things go. You fucking stupid ass. Jesus. You know, there's just so many freaking weird, stupid things to me at that event. Like there was a, I guess, an award for, like, best fan army or some shit. And, like, I was like, what the fuck? This is an award? Why the hell are they giving that out? That doesn't take talent to be a fan of something. That's fucking stupid. You know, and the names were dumb. There was like, what, the Beehive for fucking, what's-her-face, fucking Rihanna or whatever her goddamn name is. I don't know, I'm drawing a blank on their names, because I don't fucking care. Like, what other ones were there? There was the Taylor Swift, the Swifties. Great name. The Beliebers. Okay, that one's actually kind of a clever name, but... Just because they took his name, and like, it's clever if you actually thought of it, but it's like, still, it's like, where the fuck you come up with these names? Why do you have to, like, I didn't see an award for, like, the real big, big fucking fan, like, groups, and fan armies. Where were the Maggots for Slipknot? They're pretty fucking dedicated. And what about the biggest ones of all time? What about the fucking Deadheads? Those guys are like a fucking cult. How could you not have them in there? Just because they're not current anymore? I bet you there's more fucking Deadheads out there than there are, like, fucking Beliebers and Swifties and all that other gay shit. You know, the fucking Deadheads were fucking huge. Huge! But they just don't have it anymore. And that's what happened to the music industry. Speaking of music, I ended up just now receiving, I went and got out of my mailbox today, the new Metallica album, Wired to Self-Destruct. I bought a ticket to their concert that's coming to town in August, and they sent me a free CD. I was like, what? I listened to it, and you know what? It sounds exactly like fucking Metallica. They, like, have never changed their sound. And that's what's good. If you like one band, you want them to stay like they are, which that's a fucking good idea. You know, we sound like this through all of our albums. Now, the album itself wasn't as good as some of their other work, personally, my opinion. It was Metallica, it was fucking good, but it's not like, you know, the Black album way back when. That shit was fucking awesome. It just sounds exactly like they always do. You know? Which could be good, could be bad, it just depends on how you look at it. Another thing about the music industry I was kind of thinking about, and I wrote this down, just a weird thought. I was like, why is every rapper that, like, comes out today, not all of them, but, like, most of them, always have to be Lil something? Like Lil Jon, Lil Wayne, Lil Yachty. You know, like, why is everybody Lil something? You know? You know what I'm gonna be? I'm gonna be the next Lil something. Even though I'm fucking 6'4". Over 200 pounds. I'm gonna be fucking Lil Dicks. Lil Dicks in your mouth. That's gonna be my fucking rapper name. Rip it, Lil Dicks is here. Just stick it in your mouth and rear. When you look at me, you go, oh dear. That's off the top of my head. Okay, that's pretty good for a fucking shitty white guy that doesn't know anything about fucking music. Okay, I know some stuff about music. I just don't know how to play music. I'm fucking tone deaf as a motherfucker. I can't sing. But, you know, the only thing I could really think of why everybody is Lil something these days is because there was only one Biggie. Biggie was the big guy. And I think just because he was so good, it's like if you're like, oh, I'm big this, I'm big John, I'm big Wilson, I'm big fucking Goldtooth McFuckfuck. I'm big balls in your mouth. You just can't do it. Because, you know, a lot of people probably like, that's fucking disrespectful. So everyone has to, like, come in second place to this fucking dude that's dead. That died fucking a long time ago just because he was so good. It's a theory, you know. I don't know. You guys got any ideas? Is it just because, like, it can't be like a lack of creativity. I mean, these motherfuckers are famous. They're making millions of dollars, so they did something right somewhere. They wrote music. They performed it. So it can't be like, you know, they're artistic enough to fucking make music. But you're telling me they're not artistic enough to, like, and don't have enough of an imagination to come up with something besides Lil something? I don't know. I just don't understand. It's weird. You know? I don't know. Just saying, stop with the sizing and scaling of your name. Big, small, wide, skinny, tall, short. Yes, no, black, white, purple, pink. Yeah, I just think it's a weird marketing technique, if you ask me. No, there's a lot of weird marketing techniques out there. Maybe that one just fucking works. You know, saw a commercial just yesterday or today on YouTube. It was before the video started. It was the new Samsung commercial. Samsung's all like, oh, we're dedicated to making sure we give you a quality product. And all of our phones, before they go out, go through our vigorous, like, 8-point inspection, battery inspection. We inspect all of our batteries top to bottom, make sure you get the best that there is, because we're dedicated. It's like, really, guys? You guys fucked up that hard to, it's like, now you have to make your advertisement. You're not even talking about what qualities the phone has anymore. Normally, it was like, oh, get this, you know, fucking 1800 megapixel camera with freaking Bluetooth and stereo and fucking 46,000 gigabytes of storage and internet speeds up to fucking your mom's tits. Used to be all that stuff. 7.5 inch screen. Very thin, very light. With new freaking nighttime camera. And super sensitive speakers for great audio. It used to be all about that. Now it's like, hey guys, our batteries are better. They're not going to explode, I swear. Come buy our stuff. We're running out of money. Oh shit. Oh shit, this is the only company keeping Korea open anymore. Kim Jong-un is gonna kill us if we lose the Samsung name. Fucking like, Samsung goes and like, fucking Korea just goes under. That's like, that's all they're financing, I don't know. I'm sure there's other big names from there, I just can't remember. I think they're from Korea. I always second guess myself a lot. You know, as I should, I'm fucking right a lot. I'm wrong a lot, but then again, I'm right a lot as well. I just find it that I need to dump my brain of useless information. You know? So, yeah. So that was Samsung's fucking weird marketing. Like the little everything. Samsung's got their weird battery commercial now just to prove that their fucking phones aren't going to go fucking campfire in your pocket. Fucking burn your stick and melt your marshmallows right in your pants. Fucking dick catches on fire. My stick's burning. Then your fucking balls melt like a couple of marshmallows. And then you're like, oh no, this is just shitty. And you panic and you shit your pants so you can get that chocolatey graham cracker taste with the rest of this fucking campfire that's going on in your fucking shorts. That's what it comes down to. Other marketing is fucking weird. I saw last week, the guy at my work, he showed me these new chips that he got. And he says they're like these really spicy chips. They look pretty good. I want to try them. But they're called like haunted ghost pepper chips. And I was like, first off, I was thinking, okay, why haunted ghost pepper? If you're relating the haunted to the word ghost, it's kind of redundant, you know? It's repeated. You're saying haunted, which usually means like ghosts of sorts, and then you got ghost pepper, where you got the word ghost, which ghosts are haunting people because they're fucking ghosts. They're already dead. Haunted means ghost. Ghost means haunted. It's the fucking same thing. You know? It's kind of like saying fucking, these are red, reddish radishes. It's like, why'd you say red twice? It's just like the marketing ideas there just seem kind of flawed to me. They could have done better. And another thing on the same fucking bag, which was weird, I don't know why they put this on there. I was seriously confused about this one. On the bag of chips, it says made with 100% real ingredients. As opposed to what? Fucking imaginary ingredients? What do you mean fucking real ingredients? I know someone say, well, they use all natural stuff. Like, they actually use corn for the chips. And they actually salted it with real ghost pepper flakes for flavoring. And they probably deep fried them in a nice peanut vegetable oil combo for a good crisp crunch. Now, an ingredient is a fucking ingredient, okay? All ingredients are real. Okay? It doesn't matter what it is. It doesn't matter what the recipe calls for. An ingredient is real if it's in the fucking food. You can make something and be like, oh, the fucking recipe calls out for 4 sheets of minced tin foil. I guess that's how the brownies get their sparkle at the end. That's why they're called stoner brownies, because they like the sparkle. So the tinfoil gives it the sparkliness. Okay. Even though you're not putting real food product in there, it's still a fucking ingredient. You're putting tinfoil in fucking brownie mix because it's an ingredient. Doesn't mean it's good for you. Doesn't mean it fucking wasn't fucked with. An ingredient is an ingredient. If it's put in, it's 100% real. It's not fucking imaginary ingredients. We don't have fucking unicorn jizz and fucking goddamn chupacabra tit milk fucking in these things. Because those don't exist. Okay? Your fucking lollipop is not going to be fucking pressed with fucking, you know, hardened fucking Bigfoot hair. Because Bigfoot doesn't exist. Those are imaginary ingredients. When you come up with crap that's not real. Like, you know what's not real ingredients? That fucking one place out between Vegas and California. That fucking alien fresh jerky. If anybody says alien's an ingredient, they're like, no, it's not because aliens are real. Actually, you know what? That's a bad example. All these are actually bad examples. Bigfoot could be out there. We don't fucking know. Aliens are out there fucking somewhere. Are they here? I don't think so. Not maybe. I don't know. It's hard to call on that one, but yeah, part of me says probably not, and the other side says, yeah, maybe. We do have a lot of technology really fast. So I'm just saying, like, you know, the chupacabra could be real just because fucking, just because you didn't find it doesn't mean it's not there. If it moves, it can be somewhere. Because we keep finding new fucking animals all the time that we've never seen before. So who knows? I don't know. I'm just saying. Imaginary ingredients don't exist. Everything's made with 100% real ingredients. Fictional monsters could exist. We just don't know. Alright, I think that's enough. I fucking blabbed on enough. I think I got through everything I want to talk about today. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this episode. Please subscribe, share, all that crap. I fucking hate saying please subscribe. Ugh, I feel like every other fucking asshole YouTuber. It's fucking stupid. If you like what you see, you're going to fucking do it. I shouldn't have to tell you that. How many people are out there like, oh, fuck, shit. I didn't know you could subscribe because you didn't tell me. No one's that fucking, okay, I can't say nobody's that dumb because I'm sure somebody is. But, for the most part, people understand. If you like it, you're going to fucking click on it and subscribe. Then you get all my stupid shit. All my dumb rants that fucking blab on about nothing. And then you can get all my closing little bits of information like I'm going to give you here. Like I said, thanks for watching. Please do whatever the fuck you want. I'll see you on the next one. And remember, toenail clippings can easily be disguised in someone's food as long grain rice. So go ahead and fuck with whoever you got to fuck with. Have a good one.